Good afternoon. Thank you to each and every one of you are being with us today. Today we Pharma Intelligence team mark our fourth webinar and we get very amazing and enthusiastic audience like you people. I am Ajit Kotkar. I am sharing very special bond with Amrutvani College of Pharmacy because I am the alumni of Amrutvani College of Pharmacy Sangamnet. I completed my Bachelor of Pharmacy and then I did my M.Tech from ICT Mumbai. The main problem for the student during academic is that they didn't get proper guidance for future study. That's why we started this platform for all the pharma students to get proper guidance, career guidance and future study with my friend Sanjay Malge, the CMD of the Pharma Intelligence and one of the AUCOP alumni and my beloved friend who is technically helping us. I learned a lot of things from Amrutvani College of Pharmacy because of the proper guidance. I got admission in very reputed Institute of India, ICT, Institute of Chemical Technology, Mumbai. ICT is very well known for pharmaceutical sciences, bioprocess and chemical engineering. ICT this year acquired first rank in Atal Innovation Award in government universities. As per NRF ranking, ICT is in fourth position in pharmaceutical sciences. It's very well-known institute in the India. And I am very thankful to my alma mater, Amrutvani College of Pharmacy, especially our principal sir, Professor M.J. Chauhan sir, Professor Veli sir, Professor Sayed sir, all the HOD, teaching and non-teaching staff of for helping us in every critical situation and showing the support, proper guidance to path of the success. Because of their constant guidance and support, I am able to enter in one of the reputed institute of India and now working in one of the largest pharmaceutical company in India and worldwide. Before we start this event, I would like to express my sincere appreciation toward the Professor M.J. Chauhan sir, Principal of Amrutvani College of Pharmacy Sangamnet, Professor Rushikesh Veli sir, HOD of the Pharmacology Department, and GPAD Coordinator Amrutvani Kalmik sir, Alumni Coordinator AUCOP, generously helping us to make this event come together to become success. I would like to thank today's guest, Mr. Kaustubh Pawar, for accepting our request to deliver the session. We could not have done this without you. Well, I don't want to take much time of you. So very warm welcome each and everyone for the session. Enjoy your session. Thank you so much. So I will hand over the session to Sanjay, next session to Professor Veli sir to introduce our today's guest. Thank you.
Hello. Welcome to all of you. On behalf of Amrutvani College of Pharmacy, management, principal, I welcome all the delegates, all the participants for this webinar, which has been organized with Association with Pharma Intelligence Group, which is a group which has been formulated by our esteemed alumni Ajit Kotkar, Varad Mutha, and all his friends. They have arranged this group, and it is a very good activity. And because of them, we are interacting with the topper students in GPAT. Now, the objective of this webinar is to make our students aware about the studies, how to do study from the toppers of GPAT. Now, previous lecture we were having of ARI 3 rank, Vaibhav Gherge, and today we have All India rank 2, Mr. Kaustubh Pawar. And this type of series we have started, and this is the second lecture with Amatwani College of Pharmacy. And because of this, our main objective of our webinar is to make our students aware about the journey from starting a study to qualify the GPAT or get a good rank in GPAT. How to do that? I remember the quote of Mother Teresa that giving an example is easy, but becoming an example is difficult. So Kaustubh Pawar is in front of us. He has become an example. We give an example, that becomes very easy, but to become an example is very difficult. So he will share his journey of becoming an example before all of us. Okay, now talking about Amrutvani College of Pharmacy. Amrutvani College of Pharmacy was established in 2004 in rural area of Sangamnet. And from that point, the journey has started, and we have very illustrious journey. In that, we have kept the student our focus, and we are continuously guiding students for the career development. Even our first batch students were GPAT and IPAR qualified. And such type of starting we got, Amrutvani College of Pharmacy, such type of starting we started. And further, we also enhanced the placement activity. And our students are also placed in various good companies, industries. And many of students are also studying in abroad. They have done their PhD, etc., and they have joined various good organizations. So all these activities are done by Amrutvani College of Pharmacy. We have B-Pharm course. We have M-Pharm course in 3 branches, quality assurance, pharmaceutical, pharmacognosy, as well as we have research program in all these 3 branches.
Thank you, everyone. So, hello, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Sangamnet, the College of Pharmacy, Amrutvani College of Pharmacy of Sangamnet, Professor Veli sir, for inviting me to deliver this session at this college and across this platform of Pharma Intelligence, which is a unique platform which was founded by one of my friends, Sanjay Mave and Varad Muthe, as well as Ajit Kotkar. We all are the ICTNs, and I am proud to be an ICTN. So we will start with our session. So as to the session, the title is Master Plan to Crack GPAT and NIPAR. I would say it is a roadmap. If you like this session, if you like my plan, then you can say it as a master plan. So I'm so I'd like to thank again to Amrutvani College of Pharmacy. Pharma Intelligence, they are conducting this wonderful series. So we will begin with our sessions. So first of all, to know how to crack the GPAT or to prepare for that GPAT as well as want to do this. It's a tough thing. It's a tough, and we all know that. That's why what's the purpose to do this, to do the hardship and to sacrifice things actually were right or whatever the goal might be. So you have to first decide what's your purpose. So as I can say, my purpose for this journey, when I started my journey, when what's your goal for your GPAT and NIPER examination which are going to appear. So do you want to get an All India ranker or do you only want to qualify? Because this Monday will decide your future. My goal was to score about, as we all know, the total questions of GPAT, if we say, and plus 4 is the marking. So total is of 500 marks. And if we see, so when I was in when I was preparing for GPAT in 2018, I did one survey. I just found out what was the toppers or All India 1-3 rank scores. So usually it was around 260 till 2017. So till 2017, all the All India rankers had a score of around 260, 270, 250 around. So I decided in my third year that I want to score above 300. So it's a huge task which I have to do, but I have decided. And why I decided to do that? Because if I do so, then eventually I will be among top three. Because if I'm able to crack that barrier of 300, then obviously I'm going to be in a top three rank. So that was my goal. My goal was not to become an All India ranker, but my goal was to get a score above 300. So that is my second philosophy. So my second philosophy says that aim for gold, then you will land up with silver. And to get gold, aim for the world record. So I aim for the world record, that was to score above 300. And for the God grace, I was able to score 318, which is still the second highest score in the GPAT history. So likewise, I became the All India ranker. So this was the why I started, what was my purpose, and what was my goal. Now let's see how to do it. So basically for GPAT and NIPER or for any other entrance exam, the syllabus is same. We all have same syllabus of 20 subjects. For GPAT, Manipal, BITS, JSS, Bharati Vidyapeeth University, which entrance exam is conduct for masters, they have a similar exam. If you'll take the syllabus of this GPAT, usually it is similar. In case of NIPER entrance exam, they have just added two more parameters, that is mental aptitude and general knowledge. So they have there are 200 questions, so around 150 questions or 180 questions is from pharmacy, that is GPAT syllabus, and around 20 to 30 questions are mental aptitude or general knowledge. So that is the general syllabus or the paper pattern for the NIPER and for the GPAT examination. So the syllabus is same. So now the question is it possible to study each and every topic from each and every subject? It is, but it's better to study maximum topics which you have a stronghold. So I would say, rather than being jack of all, be master of most. So if you have 20 subjects, if you are master in 19 subjects, and if you are somewhat weak in one subject, it's good. Rather than wasting on a weak subject, I will say that perfect your strong subjects and go likewise, go on perfecting and mastering each and every subject. And it's good that if you get master in 20 subjects, then it's wonderful. So I will say be master of most. So this was about the syllabus. Now moving to which are the subjects and how you should move to prepare for the GPAT 21 or for NIPER 21, and if there are students from third year for 2022 also. So I would say that start with the basic subjects, the subjects which you have studied in the second year and the first year of pharmacy. So start with those like physical chemistry, organic chemistry, biochemistry, physical pharmacy, and so on. Because if you know the concepts of the basics, it will be easy for you to understand the major subjects, as all the major subjects has a foundation laid down in these basic subjects. Like if you take an example of pharmaceutics, its foundation is laid down in physical pharmacy, in microbiology, in pharmaceutical engineering. Similarly, if you take example of pharmacology, you have to know about human pathology as well as pathophysiology. Then and then only you will be able to know what drugs which we have to use for a specific disease. And after knowing the pharmacology, it comes its application part, which is of clinical pharmacy. So if you know the drugs, then and then only it will be easy to remember and to know what are the drug of choices or what are the adverse drug reactions for a specific drug, which is a part of clinical pharmacy. So likewise, each and every topic, each and every subject is correlated with one another. That's why it is important to start with basics and then move to major subjects and slowly cover up the each and every subject. And there are few allied subjects like jurisprudence, management, which are somewhat allied. Also, those subjects are also important. Because from 125 questions, usually 2 to 3 questions are there from every minor subject and at least 10 to 12 questions from major subjects. So each subject is equally important if you want to get a good score and if you want to become an All India ranker. So start with basics, then get thorough with basic concepts, move to major subjects, and at the end, you can revise all the allied subjects also. So that was the flow when I used to study. Then my next strategy or next plan is to study by step by step. So why it is so? Why it is so important? So there are few examples I have mentioned in this slide. As you can see, the first example, I have mentioned heterocyclic name reaction synthesis. So these three topics are a part of organic chemistry. As they are part of an organic chemistry, which is a basic of the medicinal chemistry. So if you directly go and start studying medicinal chemistry, it will be very difficult. If you don't know anything about name reactions, if you don't know anything about heterocyclic rings, it will be tremendously difficult to understand the structure, to understand its activity relationship and its synthesis. So that's why, as I correlated with in a previous slide, start with basics. Similarly, if you start with organic chemistry, if you know the heterocyclic rings, if you know its nomenclature, if you know its structure, then it will be easy to draw the structures of medicinal chemistry, which are usually asked in GPAT and NIPAR exams. And then if you know the structures of medicinal chemistry drugs, you will be able to understand what's its activity relationship. Because in GPAT and NIPAR, usually questions will be like this. Like if we have isoniazid, then which of the following functional group of isoniazid enhances its activity, or which of the functional of the penicillin moiety is responsible for its mechanism of action. Likewise, the questions will be there. So for that, you have to know the basic functional groups. You have to know its structural activity relationship. Moving to the next example, in this I have mentioned of pharmacology. So now how to study pharmacology? Directly going to pharmacology and studying the classification, mechanism of action, without knowing the pathophysiology and disease will be a tough job. So to crack the pharmacology subject, which is a tremendously huge subject, and most of the students thinks that it is a difficult subject. But OC, that is medicinal chemistry, and pharmacology are pretty easy subjects if you understand the concepts. So if you know the concept of disease, so if we take an example of diabetes, if you know its pathophysiology, why diabetes happens, because there is a deviation in the insulin levels, that our blood cells are not able to use the insulin, or they are not able to synthesize and release the insulin. So if you know this pathophysiology, then it will be very easy to know the mechanism of action of insulin, to know the mechanism of action of oral hypoglycemic drugs, which is a part of pharmacology. And after knowing this, it will be very easy to know the drug of choice for or any adverse drug reactions, which is a part of clinical pharmacy. So I will always suggest to go in a step-by-step process rather than to directly to the last step. Start with the first step and then gradually move on. Another example from Sutex, colloids, which contain surfactant and rest of all topics like surfactants, then types of surfactants, HLB scale, which is taught in the physical pharmacy. That is the basis of the NDDS and emulsions, which are the topics of Sutex, which are the dosage forms. If you want to formulate a liposome or if you want to formulate an emulsion, you have to know what are the surfactants you have to use. Do we have to use twins or do we have to use spans for making O by W emulsion or W by O emulsion? Likewise, similarly for biopharm, as a biopharm is a tremendously important subject for your GPAT, for your NIPER entrance exam, as well as for your future if you want to get into an R&D, F&D or any pharmaceutical industry. It's one of the important subjects. So if you want to understand the biopharm, you have to know the physical chemistry, kinetics. You have to know the dosage form from Sutex, and you have to know the ADME, that is basic of pharmacology. Then and then only it will be easy to know the calculations, that is how to calculate volume of distribution, how to calculate T half-life, how to calculate clearance rate. And then only you will be able to know the compartment model. Our dosage form, that if it is a tablet or if it is an injection, it belongs to first compartment model or second compartment model. Likewise, you have to study. So this was the way I used to study when I started preparing for my GPAT 2018. I started with basics and then correlated with the actual application of that. And that's why it was very easy to appear for GPAT exam and to crack it with a good score. Then moving to time management. This is the biggest hurdle in any student's life, because usually students they have a lot of work. They think that students have a lot of work to do, but actually they have many spare times with them. So if they sacrifice few hours of their daily, of your day, then it will be very easy to prepare. So I'm just saying that sacrifice or invest, rather than sacrifice, I will use the word of invest. Invest at least 2 to 3 hours daily for preparing for GPAT and NIPER or any other competitive exam which you are appearing. If you will do it daily preparation, it will be easy for you, because rather than studying for 8 to 6 hours in a week for a day, study 2 to 3 hours every day in a week. So it will be easy to cover each and every topic, and there won't be that much load on you. There won't be that much pressure to complete the topics. So just allow 2 to 3 hours. It can be a morning, as soon as you wake up in early morning, or at the end of the day. So just decide the 2 to 3 hours which you want to invest. Then I usually used to study 1 to 2 weeks for a minor subject. Students take lot of time to study a minor subject. You have to know what's the importance of that subject and how much marks or the weightage is allotted to those subjects. How many questions will be appeared from those subjects. So that's why from any minor subject, it will be at least 2 to 3 questions from a physical pharmacy, which is a minor subject. So for those, it is 1 to 2 weeks is more than sufficient. That's why try to cover each and every minor subject in 2 weeks. That's why it will be very easy, and you will get a time to revise at the end. For a major subject, usually 3 to 4 weeks is essential and it's enough. For pharmacology, medicinal chemistry. Now, how you can finish a subject of like pharmacology or medicinal chemistry in 3 to 4 weeks? So it's a tough job. Now you have to know that you have to study those subjects which are closely related. You have to study together, which I will discuss in the couple of next slides. So this was the time, what we can say, the plan or a time management scheme which I used to follow for my GPAT preparation, and which you can also follow. Just invest 2 to 3 hours daily. Then moving to the technique, how I prepared and how you should ideally prepare for a GPAT and NIPER exam. It's not a semester exam paper, so that you have to get it clear. In this, you have to understand the concepts in GPAT, in NIPER. You have to know the concepts, you have to know its calculation, you have to know its applications, because questions won't be straightforward. Your questions will be a little bit applied. And that's why I used to study a topic. I used to understand that topic, and I used to imagine its applications. I literally avoided and I hated to mug up. So that's why I didn't mug up or I didn't jo ratta marne ka hai, I didn't do that ratta mar thing. I tried to understand the concepts. Even if it take time, I used to invest that time. After understanding those concepts, I used to discuss with my friends and I used to explain those concepts to my friends. And that's why when I started explaining those concepts, it started getting fixed in my mind. So if we take an analogy, in microbiology, in gram staining, we use modern as a, that is potassium iodide and iodine as a fixating agent. So that's why like this. So if you explain the concept, I will say it will act as a modern. It will fix that concept in your mind permanently. And if you know the concept, it will be very easy to mark the correct answer in the GPAT and NIPAR entrance exam. And the third and most important point in my technique is that solve questions as much as possible. Solve questions because it's true. Practice is essential and practice makes man perfect. It's a true sentence. It was around 2000 questions from each subject I had solved before appearing for that GPAT 2018 exam. So if you analyze the how much preparation I had done solving 2000 questions from, I think so, 7 to 8 books as well as test series I had gone through. So I was knowing how the question might appear and what will be the correct answer if question appears like this. So that much you have to do. You have to solve question as much as you can do. Then moving to the next point, which is of notes. Like if, each and every student who I have met, they ask whether should we take notes or not. It varies from person to person. I prefer to take notes while studying. And why it is so? Because at the time of the revision, when it will be a month of December, it's time to revise. And at that, in that 1 month, you have to revise all the 20 subjects. So if you have your handy notes in your hand, your handwritten notes or the way you have studied, it will be very easy to just browse and revise all those topics. That's why I will always suggest to take notes. It will take time, but those will be the permanent notes with you for lifetime. Then for GPAT and for NIPAR exam, it's the pattern of taking notes is different than the semester exam. So that you have to know. Here you have to take notes of only bulletin points and important points. I will show you how notes has to be taken. So this is the image of my notes when I used to prepare for my GPAT examination. I have a whiteboard. On that board, I used to make notes. So these are the couple of photos which are still there with me. So in this, you can see the first figure. In this figure, I have just list down all the heterocyclic synthesis of, I think so, there is a Parnor synthesis, there is a Fischer-Indahl synthesis, there is a Martin synthesis, there is a pyridine synthesis. So like this, in the synthesis, I have enlisted each and every name reaction. And in name reaction, I have just mentioned the starting material, the end product, and the catalyst. The three parameters are only important because in GPAT, every year they try to ask one name reaction and they will ask the reactant or they will ask the end product or they will ask the what is the catalyst name reaction. Or they will give us the reaction, they will ask which is the type of this reaction, what is the name of this reaction. So like this, you have to take notes rather than mentioning a detail in detail. What are the steps or what is the use and everything, just mention the important points for name reactions. Then for in the second figure, you can see I have listed down all the important formulas from biopharm. As in biopharm, there will be question from calculations, that is biopharmaceutical calculation of T half-life, of volume of distribution, of clearance rate. So I have just listed down and mentioned all the important formulas in just one graph or one figure, you can see. So that when it was in the month of December, I just saw this image or saw these notes and I was able to recollect all the important formulas. So likewise, you have to devise your own notes. You have to make your own notes. Then moving to next, this is one of the example how I used to study the IIT values. So every year, IR and NMR values will be there in IPAR and GPAT exam. They will definitely ask IR and NMR values. So for that, you have to make, I used to make a linear scale. On that linear scale, I used to mark the different ranges like 3000, 350, 250, 260, 160, 150 of IR values. And I used to just list down the which functional group is present in that range. So that when there will be a question, okay, what will be the IR range of the unsaturated CH? And the correct answer will be about 3000. So likewise, you can make your own notes. You can make your own flow charts. You can make your own tables. But they are, those are essential. Now, the last example, I will say it is of stomata. So I have just enlisted all the types of stomata. There are five types of stomata and which drug, pharmacognostic drug is present in which of the, which pharmacognostic drug contains which of the stomata. So likewise, it will be very easy for you to recollect all the important points and you should make notes like this. So rather than writing in detail, like you used to make notes for semester, make notes. And these notes will be very handy for you for preparing for your semester exams also. So likewise, I will suggest make notes, make flow charts, make memory diagrams, whichever is pretty easy for you. So now this is the another example. This is one slide from my GPAT online Sunday sessions, which I conduct every Sunday for 1.5 hours. So in this session, I tell you how to prepare and I deliver various topics. So in this slide, as you can see, I have listed down all the important class packaging types. So we have type 1, we have type 2, type 3, type 4. So in a single slide, in a single table, you are able to go through and you are able to understand the concepts of all the four types of glass. You are able to correlate each type with one another and thus you can remember the every type of glass and its significance. So I will always suggest make notes like this so that it will be easy for you to revise, remember, understand and recollect. So this were the few types of notes which I prepared and which I tell and which I teach in my Sunday online session series. Then moving to mnemonics and tricks. So it's one of the key parameter we can say for cracking any GPAT or IPAR exam to make a mnemonic or to generate or to devise your own trick. So as you can see, this is a figure or this is a post from my Instagram page, which is a Pharmascopy by name. So in that Instagram page, I usually post such mnemonics and tricks for pharmacy preparation, GPAT and NIPA preparation. So if you see in this first post, I have listed down the mnemonic for tetracycline, its adverse drug reaction and toxicity. So the mnemonics is a Kapil Dev. So as Kapil Dev is that word can be associated with the adverse drug reaction and toxicity of tetracycline. As you can see, K stands for kidney failure, A stands for anabolic effect, P stands for photosensitivity, likewise I insipidus, L liver toxicity, D for bone defects and E for expired drugs and V for vestibular dysfunction. So likewise, so if you remember that mnemonic and if you are able to recollect the mnemonic's actual content, it will be easy for you at the time of the examination, because at the time of examination you will have 1 minute to answer usually, or 1.5 minute to answer a question. So if you know these tricks, if you know these mnemonics, it will be very easy for you to remember at the time of GPAT paper. So try to devise your own mnemonics or own tricks, or there are various pages on Instagram where usually like various content creators are trying to devise these mnemonics and they are helping students. So you can follow those pages also. Then in the second example, I have listed down the drug of choices for various seizures. So first column states the various types of seizures and the second column states the drug of choice. So in the entire only one figure, you are able to know which are the drug of choices for which seizures. So rather than reading the whole book at the time of revision, it will be easy if you just go through such stuff. Then the third and then the fourth point for how to prepare concept is to correlate. Now, why it is more important to correlate and what it exactly states. So I will always suggest and I always tell that study similar topics together and correlate various topics. Our pharmacy field, when we prepare for BPharm, we study each and every subject, starting from sootics to pharmacology, analysis, medicine, chemistry, pharmacognosy. So each and every subject we are studying. Why? It is so because each and every subject is correlated with each other. It is interlinked and intertwined with each other. There are various examples how you can understand those concepts by studying a single concept. So if you see, I have given few examples, colloids from PP, which is correlated and interlinked with the suspensions emulsions from sootics, which is a subject, which is correlated with the dispensing pharmacy, which is a different subject. So if you can see, the same concept is mentioned in the three different subjects, but they are correlated and interlinked with each other. So when you will start studying colloids, simultaneously you should study emulsions classification from dispensing pharmacy, so that you are able to cover up and study various concepts, various subjects in a single go in one sitting, and it will save your time and it will be helpful to remember and understand those concepts. Similarly, carbohydrates and amino acids, these two concepts are mentioned in three different subjects. Like organic chemistry, we have the same topics. In biochemistry, we have the same topics. And in pharmacognosy, we have the same topics. Its content is different, but we have the same topics. So if you are able to correlate all these three subjects, having the same concepts, similar concepts, it will be easy to understand these concepts from different aspects also. And you will be able to solve those questions. Because in GPAT NIPER, questions are most of the time interdisciplinary. Like the question will be coology, medicine, chemistry, and clinical pharmacy. All the three, like they will form question likewise. It won't be a straightforward question. So for that reason, you have to know the concept. Then the important is of coology. Each and every student thinks that, most of the students, I will say, ecology and medicine chemistry is a very difficult subject. It's pretty easy if you study both the subjects together, because ecology and medicinal chemistry has the same basis, same topics are repeated. Only difference in ecology is that we have to study its mechanism of action, whereas in medicinal chemistry, we have to study the structural activity relationship of an SAR and its structural activity relationship SAR of the drug and its synthesis. Only two different points are there. Various rest of all ADME, that is ADME, then classification, uses, both are mentioned in those subjects. So that's why study ecology, medicinal chemistry together, and it will be easy for you to remember. After studying that, clinical which contains adverse drug reactions and drug of choice of the same drugs which we are going to study in pharmacology and medicinal chemistry. So likewise, you have to try to correlate the same concepts through different disciplines, through different subjects. And then it will be easy to crack GPAT and NIPER exam. Now this is from my YouTube session. So I have a YouTube channel called as Pharmascopy by Kausupa, where I deliver and where I upload few sessions. So this is my GPAT online session one. In why I am showing this image, because in this session I try to cover or relate various topics. So this is an example how you can study and how you can correlate various topics. So as you can see in the first topic, which is of local anesthetic, which is from pharmacology and medicinal chemistry topic, that local anesthetic is related with pharmaceutics in injections, with ionization from biopharmaceutics, with FTIR of carbonyl compounds from analysis subject, with DOC ADR from clinical pharmacy and liposomes from pharmaceutics, and how it is so. If you will see this session on my YouTube channel, you will get a detailed idea of how you should study and how they are correlated. In a short, I will right now I will tell you that in local anesthetics we have two classifications, amide class as well as ester class. So that amide class and ester class both are a type of a carbonyl compounds. So if you will study the FTIR of those carbonyl compounds, you are able to do the analysis FTIR thoda sa idhar, So in while studying pharmacology of local anesthetics, as we are studying its medicinal chemistry classification, it contains amide class and ester class. Uska application is in analysis because the FTR of carbonyl compound is the way how we can identify these amide and local drugs. So there you can study analysis. Now, as local anesthetics, the main route of administration is parenterals, subcutaneous injections. Here we are introducing the pharmaceutics point of view. So when we are studying the parenteral, when we are studying the local anesthetics, it's better to study injections because local anesthetics are eventually and ideally administered through parenterals. So you can cover up the injection part and it will be very easy to understand the injections because you are studying its basics, that is local anesthetics. Then percentilization as local anesthetics, so the mechanism of action is dependent on the pK, which is dissociation constant, how much drug is getting ionized and how much drug is remaining unionized form. That will decide its action, that will decide its efficacy. So to know the amount of unionized and amount of unionized form, you have to know the concept of ionization, which is a part of biopharmaceutics. And after studying these points, you have to know its actual use for what we want to use procaine, for what we want to use dubicane. That is its drug of choices. And what are the adverse effects if we use those medicines? That is a part of ADR, which is part of clinical pharmacy. So likewise, each and every different component of the subject of various subjects, the components are interlinked and interrelated. So likewise, you can cover various subjects in a go. If you are able to think and imagine, if this concept is given in that topic also, and likewise, uska application hai, likewise it is related. And the liposome part, as in this right now, various industries and researchers are trying to formulate the novel formulation of local anesthetics. So when I was preparing local anesthetics, I found out that right now in current affairs, which is a part of a NIPAR exam, which is a general knowledge part. In that, they usually ask the current affairs or the general knowledge of pharmacy. So right now, liposomes is the key component or the key dosage form where researchers are working. And that wise, the look for prolonging the local anesthetic action, liposomes are being devised. So likewise, I was able to correlate its real life application, and I was able to cover the liposomes part from pharmaceutics also. So likewise, you can study. This is an another example from same session, from a different session, where I covered clinical trials. As we all know, in pharmacology, it is one of the most important concept and topic we can say in your lifetime also, when you will pursue industry, as well as from the GPAT and NIPAR examination. As clinical trial, we have to perform clinical trials. We have to perform. We have to know the different types of clinical trials. So what is actual use of those clinical trials? For which types of drugs, which type of drug applications those are used? So for new drug applications, for investigational new drug applications, clinical trials are performed. So that's why I correlated it with the types of drug applications from pharmaceutics. Then in biopharmaceutics, we have new drug application chapter, we have generic drug bioequivalence and important definitions. So that are again correlated with the clinical trials and types of drug applications. So likewise, if you are able to correlate various subjects and various topics, it will be very easy for you to understand the concept, to remember the concepts, and easily crack the GPAT and NIPAR exam. Then this was about how you should study. Now I would like to tell what exactly you should study. You should be smart while studying. Hard work is essential, but studying smart is most essential. Because in GPAT and NIPAR exam, most of the times the questions will be from the important concepts. So it will be important to study the bulletin points to know the actual points from which the questions will be asked. For example, every year they ask questions from classifications, adverse drug reactions, DOCs. So these are the few examples of which are very important concepts from which questions are asked every year or at least twice a year. So likewise, you have to narrow down your topics and study smart and study the important and bulletin concepts. Then moving to the next point, which is solve previous year question papers. Now, why it is important? So this point is the most important and the most crucial, which most of the students miss out. Because as I have mentioned, most of the time topics gets repeated. If you'll see previous year question papers, every year mentioned is also clinical trial topic concept is repeated in 2014, 16, 17, 18, as well as in this year 2020's question paper. The same concept is repeated. They tried to ask a different question from the same concept. Similarly, schedules, which is a part of a jurisprudence. Every year they try to ask a question from jurisprudence from in 2014, 15, 16, 19, 20. They have asked a question from schedules also. So if you solve the question papers, you will be able to narrow down and you will be able to know which all are the important topics, those you have to study. And if you focus on those topics, it will be very easy and you will be very confident at the time of the GPAT and NIPAR entrance exam to know ki ye question aaya to I am sure that I will be able to solve that question. And the one more point, why it is important to solve previous year question papers. Sometimes same questions get repeated, and yes, it is true. Apna jo semester exam rehta hai, jaise previous year ka semester paper rehta hai, 50% questions to get repeated. Similarly, in GPAC NIPAR also questions get repeated, but not 50%. Couple of questions at least get repeated. There is a classic example which I found out when I was right now when I was preparing for my sessions. In GPAT 2020 as well as in GPAT 2019, the same question was repeated. Just they have changed the question sentence. Question in GPAT 2020 states that pyrogen present in containers can be destroyed by heating the container at, and the answer was 1 degree Celsius force, as it is a depyrogenation temperature. Similar question. Containers may be rendered free from pyrogens by adding cleaning by. So here also they are asking depyrogenation process. In GPAT 2020 also they have asked depyrogenation process, and the answer was same, heating at 210 degrees Celsius for 3 to 4 hours. So if you see, same question has been repeated in consecutive years. So it's important to solve previous year question papers. Now this is the weightage for the GPAT examination. For NIPAR also somewhat similar weightage is given. For pharmaceutics and for allied subjects like physical pharmacy, microbiology, biopharmaceutics, engineering, 20 to 25% questions are allotted. Then for oncology, clinical pharmacy, patho, 20 to 25%, 15 to 20% for chemistry part, medicinal, organic, physical, biochem, for 10 to 15 for pharmaceutical analysis, and 10 to 15 for pharmacognosy part. So likewise, usually this is a trend by which they try to ask the questions. So if you know the weightage, it will be very easy. So if you are good in pharmaceutics and you are able to solve each and every question, so likewise you can know which concepts, which topics or which subjects you have to focus. So for final year students for who are appearing in 2021, so we have 4 to 5 months in our hand. So I will suggest to focus on these subjects, because after doing analysis of last 10 years which I have done, from that last 10 years these are the topics which have been repeated, which are very important, and GPAT or NIPAR in entrance exam they try to ask questions from these topics. So you can take screenshot of these topics so that it will be very handy. So if you state pharmacology, they try to ask question from pharmacological classification, mechanism of action, DOC and ADM, there will be question. So similarly, the topics or the concept which I have highlighted, those are the most prominently asked topics. So from Medichem, SAR, structural synthesis, from Sutics tablet is there, NDDS is there, aerosols, emulsions, and nowadays ICH guidelines, which is being asked like at least for 2 to 3 years, they are trying to ask the different ICH guidelines. So just go and revise those ICH guidelines. Then in analysis, every year they will ask the spectroscopy ka example, spectroscopy ka calculation and its numerical, IR, NMR value. UB Mass. In Cognosy, they will give a table of drugs, its clinical test, its clinical chemical constituents, and its uses, which you have to match. Such type of questions will be there. Then for PPPC, which is a minor subjects, rheology, micromeritics, colloids are their favorite. They ask kinetics, the half-life is their favorite topic. In organic chemistry, stereochemistry, name reaction, aromaticity is favorite. IUPAC names, heterocyclics, so they will ask one. Then biopharm, calculations, so such questions. Jurisprudence bola to schedules ka question rahega. So every year they will ask one or another schedules. They will ask from microbiological assays, sterilization techniques, and now it is a virus season. So we can say that they might ask the virus questions on the virus topics and the vaccine topic also. Then biochem, cycles, vitamins, that is biochemistry cycles. In biotech, recombinant DNA technology, tissue culture, which is a budding field. So likewise, you have to narrow down and you have to study important topics. So moving to the last part of this session, which is the books. So this is the set of books which I preferred and which I referred. So likewise, you can devise, you can, if you like different books and if you are able to understand concepts from those books, please feel free to go and read those books. These are the books which I used while preparing for physical pharmacy, physical chemistry, Martin. Then pharmaceutics, Alton, Lachman, and Remington are the best books. Indian pharmacopoeia and US pharmacopoeia is most important. Students miss this point because IP and USP are the source of the clinical evaluation parameters or any other topic, like in microbiological assays, limits, or disintegration limits, dissolution limits, friability test. So all these topics should be studied from Indian pharmacopoeia and US pharmacopoeia, because that is the basic source and basic origin of those concepts. Later age guidelines. So likewise, then for revision, you can study Pearson, which is by Umang Shah. So it is one of the most widely used book. Everybody at least once or twice they have gone through that book. So for revision, it is the best book, I will say, because they have given topics in a systematic way and in a tabular form, in a bulletin form, so you can use those. For pharmacology, you can revise with KD Tripathi, and it is a book called Spursh Gupta. So review of pharmacology, if I remember it correctly, review by pharmacology by Spursh Gupta. So they have given pharmacological concepts in a bulletin point. That bulletin points will be very useful for your GPAT and NIPAR exam. For question papers, we have Inamdar, which is one of the most widely used. Then apart from that, we have Pearson, Muhammad Ali, Piyush, or various test series which you might get online or from the classes. So those you have to study. So this was the entire list of the books which I preferred and which I referred. They are actually the reference books, so that is also one point. Try to study from the reference books, because your concepts will be cleared from those. So I would like to end my session by a thank you note. And I will always try to say that imagine the concept. If you are able to imagine the concept, you will be able to understand the concept. And if you are able to understand the concept, you are able to gain the knowledge, you will improve daily. So that is the flow, or that is the philosophy, that is the mindset which I've used to prepare for my GPAT and NIPAR and henceforth in my life, that imagine, understand, and improve daily. Thank you very much. Thank you, Amritwani College of Pharmacy, and thank you, Pharma Intelligence, for inviting me on this session. Thank you.
Thank you, Kostu, for this wonderful session on GPAT and NIPAR. Now we will take few questions from audience. There are many questions. We will pick a few important questions. Like there is one question from Pratibha Shinde, that is there any online preparation for MCQ? Can we prepare GPAT online?
For GPAT online, there are various MCQ. YouTube channels, and there are various Instagram pages also. So if you'll just go and browse your Instagram and your YouTube for preparation of pharmacy or GPAT, you will get many YouTube channels. As such, website for specifically for GPAT, I'm not able to recollect the specific site, but you will get many sites.
Okay, thank you. There is another question from Ashwini Mohite that she want to know that subject wise question book, which book she should prefer, like if she want to prepare subject wise MCQ test.
Okay, so for subject wise MCQs, you can prefer Inamdar. In Inamdar, Companion for GPAT is the actual name, and the author is the Inamdar. So in that, they have given the questions from pharmaceutics, pharmacology, clinical pharmacy. Likewise, they have segregated. Then the Pearson by Umang Shah, they have also given questions by subject wise. Piyush is there, Muhammad Ali is there. These are the four books which I can say you can refer.
Okay. As you know, there are multiple or innumerable structures in medicinal chemistry. So students find difficult to remember or draw it. So how to prepare, or are medical structures in medicinal chemistry important, or it is necessary? So how to plan, or what type of question would be asked on that structure?
So medicinal chemistry is, first of all, the most important topic. In medicinal chemistry, we have to know the structure and we have to know the SAR. So for that, the best process or the best technique or the best plan is to revise and repeat and draw. Revise is the only technique and the only way to remember the structures. If you'll keep reading the structures, you won't be able to understand, as well as you won't be able to recollect. So just take a piece of paper and draw those structures without looking into the book. First of all, by looking into the book, and then without looking the book, so that when you will get those structures fixed in your mind, at that time you will be able to know which heterocyclic ring is present. So that is the technique for studying organic chemistry as well as for medicinal chemistry. Practice those structures and those reactions. The second question was that the second part of the question was how the questions will be there. So the questions will be based upon its application. For example, isoniazid contains which of the following heterocyclic ring? And the correct example, the options will be pyridine, pyrazine, pyrimidine, piperidine. The correct answer is pyridine. So for that, you have to know the structure of the isoniazid, that it contains the pyridine moiety and the hydrazine moiety attached by the amide linkage. So if you know this structure, it will be easy for you to solve those questions. Second type of questions from medicinal chemistry will be based on its SAR, structural activity relationship, that which of the following functional group will enhance the activity of, we say, penicillins, and there will be following options. So for that, you have to practice the structural activity relationship. So likewise, questions will be there. So if you'll go and revise those questions from Inamdar, you will get a pretty idea how the questions and how you should prepare.
Okay. There's another question from Akshay Bhambre that if you want to qualify or get into the top five in GPAT, so how many questions he should solve to qualify and to get into top five?
So for getting top five, right now the average score, if we say from GPAT 2018-19, the average score you have to get above 300. It is the average score, or about 280 marks for getting into All India rank 5. So usually we have 125 questions. The key point here, it is to solve maximum correct answers and minimum wrong answers. Because whenever you will get a wrong answer, you will get a wrong answer, then it won't be a minus one. Actually, it is minus one, but if we'll calculate, it will be minus five. So correct answer ke plus four the, plus ek chala jayega. So it will be actually minus five. So score will drop down by the 5 points. So that is the important point. Solve maximum correct. So jitne bhi sure ho aap, solve those questions. Tukke baaji kam karo. And how many questions you should solve? So around 80 to 90 questions you have to get it correct. And around 5 to 10 questions, if you'll get incorrect, you will be in a range of 300 plus score, and it will be sure that you will be in top 5 rank.
Okay. There is a question from Sakshi Deshmukh. Which year would we prefer to appear for GPAT, in third year or fourth year? As you know, many students appear in third year only, but they won't able to score, so their confidence level gets down. So she should appear in third year, or she can directly appear in fourth year?
So first of all, you can appear जब हमारा टाइम था तब थर्ड ईयर का स्कोर वैलिड नहीं था, बगर नाउअडेज इट इज वैलिड. सो इट्स बेटर टू अपीयर इन थर्ड ईयर बिकॉज यू विल गेट टू नो हाउ क्वेश्चंस आर देयर, हाउ द एनवायरमेंट इज देयर. सो इट विल बी अ प्रैक्टिस टेस्ट और प्रैक्टिस मैच, यू कैन से, फॉर थर्ड ईयर, व्हेन यू विल अपीयर फॉर थर्ड ईयर, एंड यू विल गेट टू नो. सो दैट रादर देन गेटिंग डिसअपॉइंटेड इफ यू स्कोर लेस इन थर्ड ईयर, take it as a challenge and take it as a practice test, practice match, and then do your best and give your best in the fourth year, which is the actual important year, we can say.
Okay, so that's all about question and answer session. So I would like to thank Kostub Pawar for this wonderful session and taking his valuable time from his hectic schedule and to guide students and plan their journey for GPAT. I also thank you, Amrutvani College of Pharmacy, especially Principal Dr. Chauhan and Professor Veli sir and Professor Kalmek sir for their relentless support to Pharma Intelligence and approving this session for collaborative with AVCUP family. So now I hand over the session to Professor Veli sir for announcement of the next session that is coming Sunday. Thank you.
Hello. Good evening, everybody. So I want to thank Crystal Power for doing an excellent thing. And I'm confident that it is good to our students as well as other participants. So we are told students in systematic manner, I hope that it will be very helpful to all the participants. So I thank you for principal management, Amrutvani Pharmacy Sangam, and also Pharma Intelligence Group for collaborating with us. It's a fantastic session of today's.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, college.
So, session on September, next Sunday, 13th September. Next September.
Thank you, everyone, for participating in this session. I hope you will also join for next session, that is how to prepare for GATB and CIB. This is the one of the most important exam to be is being conducted by
Sanjay and give a lecture. All participants are requested to again join next session because she is ARI 5 and she is going to guide us. Thank you very much.
No, thank you, everyone. See you.
Now I want to hand over to Sanjay.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. We'll see you in the next session. That is by Sanjay Patak. She is AR5 in C.